All right, so hey everyone, and welcome to this video. So this video is basically will be revolving around Sigint OS. It has a latest release of 2.0, and in this particular video we'll be seeing like how to install it step by step, and we'll try to configure RTL SDR within this particular video. If not, the next video will be coming up here, and we'll be installing in that. So let's start with our Workstation 17 Pro, which we have already installed, the VMware Workstation. And in this, let me just put up my ISO image, which I have downloaded directly from the Sigint website. I'll mention that in the comment. I'll be mentioning the link down in the description and you can download it up from there. So here is the 2.0 community edition, which has been released. And apart from this, I'll try to build out a VMDK file, and we'll try to upload it somewhere in the cloud so that you can directly import it to your VMs. So let me just go next, select some others, and let me make it Sigint OS2. So before beginning, like what all are the things which has been newly there in Sigint OS 2.0, which is like we have the SRS REN 4G and we have open 5GS support. So hopefully it will be supporting the new radios along with the 5G and the 4G spectrums. And continuing with our installation, I'll make it store as a single disk. And I like to customize the hardware for this. Let's the processor be one. And let us give it a 2 gigs of RAM. And finish. Now let's try to power it on. The GUI looked pretty decent as compared to the earlier versions, with some dark graphics on the back end and a nice progress bar which can be seen. So let me just quickly fast forward it. Okay, so we are here and let's try to install it. Here you can see like there is an upgrade available. But initially, let us first install the system and then we'll try to upgrade. Well, generally, I don't prefer the GUI versions of the Linux distros because it's really slow. And this one also is basically coming from the Ubuntu Linux family and moving out pretty slow. So let me just quickly fast forward it and get the installation prompt. Okay, so finally we are into the installation prompt, and let me quickly go to select the language. I clicked on next, and the next I'll be normal installation, and I'll select the third party add-ons and along with, and the installation just started. Okay, and it will take some time, so let me just quickly fast forward it. Okay, so you can see like it's been installed and you'll be getting up this message. I'll click on restart now. And in the meanwhile, while it is restarting, there are a few things which you need to be considering while installing your operating system. So the first thing is you need to change up the time zone while installing, otherwise you'll be getting up an error. And apart from it, you need to select the LVM, the local volume manager, along with the entire disk. Then only this system will be installed. Okay, as you can see, like we have installed and we are booting from our hard disk itself. And the last thing which I would like to convey for this video is like it takes a lot of effort for us to make such videos. So your like and subscribe really matters to us. So please do keep on hitting the like button down below this video. Thank you. Thanks a lot for your support.